Hi, I'm Beiyan Zhou, the corresponding author of this article from UConn Health.
I'm Chuan Li from UConn Health, the first author of our article.
We would like to introduce a novel macrophage function annotation system, which we have developed based on single-cell transcriptome profiles and our original algorithms, named MacSpectrum. Macrophages play critical roles in many diseases and often the most abundant immune population in almost all tissues. Macrophages are also known for their highly plastic activation capacity, which allow them to exert swift, fine-tuned, and diverse responses for immune defense and tissue maintenance. This presented high difficulties to capture their heterogeneous phenotypes in various tissues and disease contexts.
Extensive efforts have been invested, and several models were proposed to understand macrophage actions in complex settings. However, as many researchers have observed that these models, including multiple subtypes or polarized activation models, often fail short to provide a comprehensive picture that allows us to annotate their actions under different tissue or disease settings. As shown in this figure, adipose tissue macrophages from lean or obese mice displayed no similarity with bone marrow-derived macrophages stimulated with Th1 or Th2 stimuli. More importantly, many well-defined markers were either detected in field cells or displayed no clear pattern that allow understanding of the inflammatory characters of obese ATMs.
In summary, these observations suggest currently available methodologies are inefficient at capturing relatively subtle differences within one population, which was also discussed in a recent review article acknowledging the computational challenges for single-cell unsupervised cell clustering. So we decided to build our own platform.
Our strategy is to depict macrophage activation states along two dimensions: the macrophage polarization, indicating how inflamed they are, and activation-induced macrophage differentiation, or terminal maturation, suggesting how activated they are. We then created two indices with original organisms and termed them as MPI and AMDI to depict such two dimensions respectively. Higher MPI indicates more inflammatory states, while higher AMDI indicates more complete terminal maturation. The system aims to capture the dynamic, full-spectrum activation states of macrophages under various conditions, and is named as MacSpectrum. MacSpectrum consistently identifies known features of macrophages from human and mouse origins in vitro or in vivo models, and as bulk or single-cell RNA-seq formats, such as the dynamic activation waves revealed in response to pathogens exposure along the MPI axis, or the distribution dynamics of freshly isolated ATMs under lean or obese conditions. We also want to point out that cells on MacSpectrum can be gated according to their MPI and AMDI values for further analysis, such as signaling pathway enrichment, signature gene identification, or activation program analysis. For example, we applied MacSpectrum to identify a set of diabetic risk genes in human circulating monocytes isolated from obese patients before or after bariatric surgery, validated in other datasets.
For more examples and application of MacSpectrum, please check out our article. We are now also providing a web version of MacSpectrum for any researchers to use for their own project. We believe, with its unprecedented resolution, MacSpectrum will not only bring more insight into macrophage biology, but also open up new venues for translational applications, such as biomarker identification of diseases, the precision medicine development, as well as drug screening.